Pierre, thanks for being with us today.
Thanks, Dave. Great to be here.
I want to start today with your giving us a brief overview of your operations.
Yeah, so Nutriband is a pharmaceutical company primarily focused on developing products in the transdermal space. Transdermal meaning delivery through the skin. People may be familiar with nicotine patches. We use the similar technologies for medications. We have three core business lines. We have our 4P Therapeutics subsidiary, which is a clinical research facility in Atlanta, Georgia. We conduct clinical trials for small domestic clients, ranging all the way to multi-billion dollar Nasdaq listed companies. We also have a manufacturing subsidiary in Charlotte, North Carolina, where we manufacture white label, innovative transdermal products, primarily for a number of clients around the United States. We also, and more importantly, develop our own internal pipeline. So our core focus internally is to improve the safety profile of transdermal drugs that are currently existing on the market today and make sure that they're safe for not only for patients, but safe for patients and physicians and payers to feel comfortable prescribing these medications, which have had a bad reputation over the last decade.
Okay. Today you announced a patent on your Aversa technology. What is that technology?
So Aversa is a technology that we've developed at 4P Therapeutics, which uses aversive agents on the back of a patch to make patches safer from abuse and accidental misuse. This is primarily focused in the opiate space. We're using our Aversa technology primarily to improve the safety profile of fentanyl patches, which is used for the treatment of pain. When used correctly, these patches are extremely effective. However, unfortunately, over the last number of years, there's an issue with accidental misuse and purposeful misuse and just incorrect exposure to these patches, which has resulted in a number of deaths and hospitalizations.
So they're able to reverse engineer the patch and take the fentanyl out?
Essentially, that's what will happen. You'll have people that will extract the residual fentanyl from a patch. Fentanyl, as many people know, is up to 50 times stronger than heroin. There's a huge aftermarket need and want for this drug in certain communities. And then unfortunately, there's also an issue with accidental misuse. So there's been a number of cases over the last decade where a child, for example, has picked up a used patch out of the garbage. They have then chewed on the patch, put the patch in their mouth, and or put their fingers in their mouth after use. And unfortunately, it's resulted in a number of deaths in the United States.
Okay, so your patch prevents that. They can use it. They can't get the fentanyl out of it.
Correct.
And can prevent a lot of deaths and misuse of those patches. What's the commercialization plan? Is there any opportunity to partner with Big Pharma?
It certainly is, yes. So the FDA, firstly, are really calling out for solutions in this space. Everybody tends to focus on opiates in the oral category. So you think of Oxycontin, you think of pill popping, you think of pill mills. Unfortunately, everybody overlooks the fact that transdermal opiates have a huge role to play in the opiate crisis here. The opiate crisis has also been shadowed over the last year or two by the COVID pandemic. But we feel that once COVID starts to rescind back into the abyss again, that we're going to be really surprised at what damage the opiate crisis has essentially done to the nation as well.
How big is the market opportunity for this technology we're talking about?
So we like to take everybody back to around 2015 when this drug was selling well, when people were not aware of the issues surrounding the drug and the residual extractions of the remaining fentanyl. And the market size was a multi-billion dollar market size globally. So we feel that we can essentially take the market back to that level again by making this drug safe. And when we get patients access to this drug, when we get physicians comfortable prescribing this drug, which has become a big problem, there's a liability issue now essentially with prescribing this drug that doesn't give patients access to the drug, and then payers won't pay for the drug. So it comes full circle. And that's resulted in a decline in the market size because of that reason. So once we can make this drug safe again, we feel there's definitely an opportunity to be back in that multi-billion dollar space again, and we will certainly be the number one safest product on the market.
One of the things I like about your company is while you're developing this patch, and hopefully maybe you partner with Big Pharma at some point, you're still generating revenue. So tell us about the business lines that are generating revenue.
Yeah, we've put a serious focus into our subsidiaries to make sure that we are self-sufficient to an extent. Our 4P Therapeutics subsidiary that conducts our clinical trials is operational, it's self-sufficient, it funds itself, it runs itself. And we also were able to develop and create new relationships, new systems that we can apply to our own development and then also has created somewhat of a reputation in the space, which I think is really important for us at this time. Our manufacturing subsidiary is profitable month over month at the moment, so that's another positive addition. And really, we're at a position now where we've done a capital raise to work on our internal pipeline, and the rest of the business is funding itself.
Excellent. So you raised $6 million with this uplisting to NASDAQ. How do you deploy that capital?
We're really focused on Aversa right now. So the primary reason for the capital raise to begin with was to raise enough capital to begin our clinical trial for Aversa. We like to look at Aversa that we haven't changed the drug matrix. We haven't changed the product itself. We haven't changed the internal components of these patches. We changed two external components, which makes the trial very simple and makes the understanding of the product very simple. It's worth pointing out as well that Aversa is not a new drug by any means. Aversa is a technology added to an existing drug. So we can prove the model with fentanyl, and then we fully plan to make the full opiate family safer again in this space as well.
So this is a technology, a drug that exists. You've simply changed the delivery platform. So what about your preclinical data?
Our preclinical data has been strong. We've conducted a lot of preclinical work in-house at our 4P Therapeutics clinical subsidiary. So we've done our own extraction tests. We've tested trying to take the drug out of the patch using water and alcohol. And we've used our aversive agents on the back. And we've been able to have pretty positive results that we're in a position now where we feel very confident to move forward with the trial.
Does anyone else have this technology, this delivery platform?
No, not in the style that we have developed this product. The nice thing about what we've developed, again, is it's very simple. We don't change the drug itself. We simply add two food-grade substances on the back of a patch. Our technology essentially deters all of these routes of abuse. So if you try to boil the fentanyl patch to extract fentanyl or try to dissolve it in alcohol, it releases the backing layer and the permeable release liner, which combines with the drug and destroys the drug. We also have, if you try to smoke it, you're smoking the two ingredients that we put on the back of the patch, which is denatonium benzoate and capsaicin. So the most bitter substance on the planet, combined with red pepper spray, essentially. So it makes it almost unbearable or impossible for somebody to extract the drug through these methods.
Gareth, in closing, what's the essential value proposition? Why should investors look closely at your company today for investment?
So we feel that we're creating a new market in a overlooked space. The opiate pandemic is going to be public enemy number one again very shortly. I think it's going to be very surprising how many people have overlooked patches as a problem in this space. And not only are we creating huge value proposition in terms of the market that we could capture, but we're also solving a problem where people don't have access to these drugs because of the liability concerns. And we're solving a problem where physicians and payers will be comfortable prescribing these drugs again to patients with our technology.
Gareth, thanks for being with us today.
Thanks, Dave.